I had been at the wheel of this bright red Jeep Compass all the way from Bombay and was now in the high Himalaya in Himachal Pradesh. One of the reasons of this road trip was to experience a white winter. But now, as I was about to cross over the district border from Kinnaur to Spiti, I was wondering whether I would find the winter landscape that I was after. I had driven past snow on the side of the road. I had even come across waterfalls frozen solid and curtains of icicles. But those white snowed out vistas that I was after were missing. Yet, I wasn't too disappointed. The scenery was dramatic, the car was running like a charm, and my iPod was playing fitting music to complement the drive. Spiti is essentially a summer destination, which is why there was hardly any traffic on the road at this time of the year. This is also the reason why most of the dhabas on this road were shut. The only one open was the one at Hurling. Of course, the fare was very simple. I was lamenting the lack of snow allowed, and the lad who was roasting the tasty parathas on the wood stove stopped what he was doing and looked at me and he said, "Drive on, my friend, drive on." And he was right, because within a few kilometers of leaving Hurling behind, I came upon the first flakes of snow gently floating down. As we drove deeper and deeper into Spiti, the snowfall intensified and the landscape that was brown slowly changed to white. By the time we got to Kaza, the district headquarters of Spiti, the snow was coming down thick and heavy. I headed straight to the fuel pump, because I knew that if the snowfall continued, the tanker bringing the fuel to Kaza would probably not make it for a few days. And in that time, this fuel pump would run dry. So the first thing I did was tank up. We're tanking up at the world's highest petrol pump, a gas station. It is at 3,740 meters above mean sea level. In the winter is really cold, and I mean really, really cold. This is the kind of cold that worms its way into every layer that you have on and chills your bones. Water freezes in pipes, causing them to fracture, and sometimes there is no electricity for days. In fact, most locals can't wrap their heads around the fact that someone would actually want to visit Spiti during the winter. But the good folks at the Sakya Abode homestay acknowledge that there are some mental people who like doing crazy stuff, and so they stay open during the winter. We headed there and were soon warming ourselves around the wood burning hearth.
Good morning from Kaza. It's minus 5 degrees and it fell to about minus 18 degrees last night. So we covered the car up. The Jeep is under this plastic tarpaulins. The bonnet's been covered just to see that the temperature doesn't fall to such a low degree in the car that everything freezes. So now we're going to unpack it and start off and start our day. Here we go. One shot, one crank.
Besides a white winter, the other reason to come to the Spiti Valley at this time of year is to get a crack at photographing the snow leopard. And since the guest house had some information about the whereabouts of a mother and cubs, we set off to try and sight them. As you can see, the visibility isn't great, so we've decided to stop and watch close to where the mother and the cubs have been seen. The local dhaba is not open for business today due to extreme weather. But fortunately, we are prepared for such circumstances. And brewed some coffee to go with the delicious egg and cheese sandwiches that the landlady had prepared and packed for us. In truth, this waiting and watching was turning out to be quite pointless. Taddan mata dukan. Mrs. Snow Leopard also seemed to be shying away from this extreme weather like the dhaba man. Never mind the fact that she has the word snow prefixed to her name. Then we got word that she'd been spotted somewhere else and we should rush there. But I'd had enough. I wasn't going to waste my day in the pursuit of some whimsical cat.
You know, I'm sure there's a bed waiting for me in Dr. Dixit's dormitory for the demented. Because you have to be a little mental to come to Spiti in the winter. You can see the roads are snowed out. It's minus 8 degrees. I actually came here to see a snow leopard. But honestly, I'm having so much fun with this car that I don't care whether I see the snow leopard or not. In fact, I've given up hope of seeing it. I'm just going to have some more fun with the car.
What followed was pure 4x4 bliss. I followed Jeep's go anywhere, do anything mantra to the T. And the compass happily and enthusiastically complied with everything I asked of it.
Sure, mama, look at me. Won't you give your love to me? Sugar mama, what you done? Sugar mama, let's have fun. Sugar mama, you stay with for a while. Sugar mama, just a baby, I'll do this tall. Sugar mama, 6 feet and you're 31. Sugar mama, sugar mama, let's have fun. Sugar mama, you're so fine. Sugar mama, you're so fine. Won't you let me taste your cherry wine? Taste your cherry wine.
Gaza, which is the district headquarters of Spiti, is not exactly buzzing during the winter. But that doesn't mean that residents are in hibernation either. I saw them go about their chores even during heavy snowfall. My base in Gaza was a Sakya abode homestay, and since it is one of the few places that stays open during winter, the other guests were a bunch of ice climbers who got their kicks from scrambling up frozen waterfalls around Spiti. I certainly wouldn't term Sakya as basic, because not only did they have warm hearths burning constantly, the food was absolutely delightful, from spicy masala omelets and yak meat curry to meat momos and local delicacies. Every meal was a lip-smacking and finger-licking delight. We would spend the time before and after meals swapping travel stories, since we had so many adventure tales to share amongst us. On the day I was to head out of Gaza, I woke up to heavy snowfall. It had been snowing non-stop for 32 hours and there was about 10 inches of snow on the road. I had 130 kilometers of narrow and high mountain roads with snow and fog ahead of me.
We started from Gaza at 8 o'clock in the morning. It's packed and it's cloudy and the snow's coming down. It's not stopped incessantly. And there is an 8 inch layer of snow on the ground. Luckily, it's powdery snow, so we can make tracks. But we're the first car making tracks. No one has gone through as yet. But with this compass and its very reliable 4x4 modes, I can go ahead with confidence.
Eventually, I had to stop and put on snow chains, because I would often have to stop on an incline and then walk ahead over the crest of the incline to see where the road led. chains would give me a better grip starting off from such situations. And they really did. So I put one on the front right and one on the rear left. When we started off the next day from our overnight halt, the clouds had peeled away to reveal a bright blue sky. I had many miles to go before I would park this Jeep in Bombay, but I was satisfied I had found the white winter I had been looking for. As we left the last of the snow behind, my iPod randomly started playing one of Bollywood's most iconic Jeep songs.
मेरे सपनों की रानी कब आएगी तू आए रुक मस्तानी कब आएगी तू बीती जाए जिंदगानी कब आएगी तू चलिया तू चलिया